Hey, hey, Nana Prep here, and today we're going to talk about hyperinflation. Are you ready? Hyperinflation, it is upon us. It is slowly creeping up on us. Things are crazy. We're looking at up to 40% increases in prices in most items. That's double. That's almost double. And it's not going to get any better. The fuel is going up. The lack of drivers. The trucks aren't getting fixed because the parts for the trucks to fix them are months out. The majority of them we buy overseas. And we all know the shipping isn't great coming, you know, importing either. It's just getting bad, 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 bad. So you really need to be getting ready. And, you know, most of us who have been prepping for a while will probably already have these things on hand. So this is really kind of a list for the beginners, the ones that are, you know, starting to go, you know what, I really don't want to go through this again like we did a year ago. Let's prepare. So here's a quick list of things that you can go get to help you through this hyperinflation. Meat, stockpile the meat. We all know that hamburger, what is it, 10 pounds is like $40 now. 40 freaking bucks. It's bananas. So when you can't get it on sale, go ahead and get it on sale. You can can it up. You can sort it through and freeze it. There's all kinds of ways to store hamburger. And you know, hamburger and any other meat that you can get a hold of cheap. Now's the time. It's not going to get any better. In fact, it's going to get way worse. Water. This goes without saying. You should always be storing water, especially bottled water. Jugs of water is even better. You need water to cook with. You need water to keep up your hygiene. And of course, you need water to drink. You can't have enough water. So buy it. Get the water. Store it. You've got room. Trust me, you've got room. Medicine. Now, we saw with the pandemic how the cold and flu medicine went bananas. Don't let that happen again. I fully expect us to be shut down by winter. You heard it here first. We will be shut down by winter. So get that cold and flu medicine. Now you know you can only buy it, you know, one at a time. So, you know, when you go to the store, pick one up. Tylenol, ibuprofen, antacids, antibacterials, alcohol, peroxide, bandages, all of those things you need to be picking up and storing. They, you know, do have a shelf life, but the shelf life is a lot longer than what says on the box. Now, watch for prescription drugs, however. Their shelf lives are different, so do your research. In fact, some of those can become dangerous once they have expired. So when you're dealing with prescription medications, make sure you do your research. Talk to your doctor. Storing them in the freezer helps a lot as well. Getting a basic first aid kit will have your tweezers and your scissors and your, you know, bandages and things like that. So try to get yourself a good first aid kit. That'll get you started. They have cold packs and hot packs and everything in it. Cooking fuel. Don't forget the cooking fuel. You know, something may happen to our supply of, you know, gas or electricity or anything. And even if it's just temporary. So be it propane, butane, Coleman type liquid fuels. Charcoal. Charcoal doesn't go bad. Charcoal is relatively inexpensive. It stores easily. All you have to do is keep it dry. It also heats well. So keep that in mind as well. And heats quite well. Do not buy charcoal with the lighter fluid in it. Buy plain old charcoal. Giant bags for like $15. tools, manual tools, hammers, screws, nails, things that do not require battery or electricity. You may need these zip ties, duct tape, things of that nature. It's great things to have on hand. You never know what you're going to need and when you're going to need it. Clothing, seasonal clothing in particular. Keep in mind, if things do go south, you're going to be working manually a lot more than normal. Outside gardening, fixing things, fetching water, things of that nature. You know, throw a couple of pairs of jeans or bib overhauls in a Rubbermaid tub and store it away, okay? Clothes wear out. Clothes are getting expensive. They're going to get more expensive. Very few of our clothes are made here in the United States. It's India or China. So that is going to be posing a problem here before long. Hit the thrift store. Put a couple of coats back. You know, what if something happens to your coat? You're not going to want to be without a coat. Also, work boots or tennis shoes. Grab a couple of pairs and store those back as well. Your shoe size is likely not to change. You know, there's going to be a fuel shortage with corn being up 40%. It's going to get really expensive. So if you can get some gas cans to put away, great. If you can't, I get it. But if you can, put a few gas cans away. Same with the guns and the ammo. Those go without saying as well. You know, this whole logistic sector of our supply is just turning to shit completely. So it's not getting any better. It's not going to get any better. In fact, it's probably going to get a lot worse. Batteries, you know, kind of do an inventory. What do you got that you're going to be running off a battery? Make sure you've got those size batteries stored. You know, other things that are basic prepper type things are precious metals and gems that you can use to barter with. Alcohol and booze also can be used to barter with, and they can be used to make medicines with as well. You know, keep yourself an apothecary so that you, you know, have these things on hand when you need them. Paper products, you know, we've been here, done that. Don't be panic buying. Just grab an extra package when you go to the store, and you already do. Just grab two. You don't have to grab 2,000. But we've seen it happen, and it's probably going to happen again. So anyway, there's a quick list to get you started on getting ready for what's coming, because it's coming again. And there's no reason for us not to be ready this time. Don't panic. Don't be scared. Be prepared. Get some things stored. Put some things back. That way, when we lock down again, you're golden, like I was last time. I didn't have to go panic buy. So make sure you don't have to go panic buy this time, too. All right. I love you. Nana Prep out.